Hello and welcome to another travelogue edition of C++ Weekly. As always, if you're not interested in this kind of thing, please feel free to skip it. I'm going to split this episode into two parts. One will be a bit more of a trip report about C++ on C, the conference, and then the other one will be about the time that we spent in the London area. In July of 2024, my family and I traveled to England for C++ on C and to spend some time exploring the London area. We left on Sunday and arrived nice and early on Monday morning.
Welcome to London. The local time is 6:22. We'll be taxiing in for a few more minutes, so please remain in your seat with your seatbelt fastened and carry a light in the room until the aircraft is ready to complete stop at the gate and the captain turns off the seatbelt sign.
The official C++ on C conference website recommends several different options for how to get from Heathrow to Folkestone, but we opted for something different I found while looking at train schedules. We took the Elizabeth line from Heathrow to Stratford, wandered around the Stratford Shopping Center, then got a little misplaced trying to find our way over to Stratford International, which is a completely different train station. If you're walking out of the main Stratford station, you need to turn left and walk on a walkway that goes back over the station that you just left. From there, you walk through an open-air mall kind of thing and hang a right until you get to Stratford International. Important note that this is Stratford, not the famous Stratford-upon-Avon that Shakespeare is from that you are used to. Look for the southeastern line to Ramsgate and then get off in Folkestone Central. Fortunately, our Airbnb hosts were very gracious this morning and allowed us to check in early. We got in, dropped off our bags, then headed out. Now, again, a comment, I and my family have some dietary restrictions, and so being able to do vacation rental, such as Airbnb, is a critical part of our travel so that we can cook for ourselves and provide our own food. A very important part of dealing with jet lag is to get straight out and get the sun on your face. This helps you to adjust much more quickly to the local time zone. If you stay inside and take a nap, you're not going to adjust very quickly. So get out, do something. Folkestone was at one time an active pier and harbor, with the train running right down to the ocean. We walked out to the harbor pier arm. Then we found some fish and chips and found our way up to Lees Cliff Hall. This is the venue for C++ on C. While the hall and town of Folkestone are starting to show their age, this is truly a unique location for a C++ conference. The conference is well run with great speakers, and I do recommend coming here. FYI, Americans don't buy hot dogs in cans, but all of Europe somehow seems to think that canned sausage is an American hot dog. I don't understand this. You can find this in nearly every country that we've been to, and it is very strange to us. It's worth noting that Folkestone is also the location where you can put your car in a train to take it on the channel under the ocean. We went along with our friend Jan back in 2022 to make this trip, and it was definitely a thing to do. It is also great that we took this opportunity this morning to explore Folkestone, as this was one of the few good weather days we would see on this entire trip. This was the first day of conference workshops, so it was very quiet around the conference center, and we took the opportunity to catch up with friends before heading to buy groceries and make our way back to the vacation rental. My personal obligations were completed on the first morning of the regular conference, so I took some time during lunch to go and meet my family at the local Folkestone Museum. As one does, if you've seen my other travelogues, I try to do this with my family wherever we happen to be. And then I tried out some pie with mash and liquor. If you're ever in Folkestone, you should check out Flo's. For those don't know, pie is a meat-filled savory pastry pie. This is a normal hand pie. Most cultures have something like this. Mash is mashed potatoes, not much different than you would expect if you are familiar with mashed potatoes. And liquor is the particularly surprising part, as this is a loose parsley-based sauce. It has nothing to do with alcohol at all. Over the week, I took the opportunity to go on a couple of runs and explore the beach. I really lucked out one morning with spectacular running weather that ended up turning foul later in the day. My family spent some time exploring up the East Coast from Folkestone, getting in lots of walking and exploring local beachside communities while getting trapped into conversations with the people running the small museums, as they were the only visitors at the time. A huge part of conference going is to see old friends and make new friends. I highly recommend that you take the time to do this. So here are some conference tips to get the best experience out of attending a programming conference. Number one, it is okay to miss some sessions. Don't feel like you have to go to every session of every day. Related to this is that you should take advantage of the, quote, hallway track. This is the most important and unofficial part of any conference. This is the time where you meet other people who have the same interest as you, in between sessions, where you get to discuss the content, careers, C++, and anything else that happens to come up. Phil, the organizer of C++ on C, does a great job of leaving plenty of time for this aspect. Third, get out and see people during the after-hour stuff. Don't feel pressured to drink alcohol. Alcohol is very common during these social gatherings, and it's personally my hobby to try local beers. However, if you want water or soda, have that. People are unlikely to notice. If they do notice, they should not care. If the people that you're hanging out with care that you're not drinking alcohol, you really need to find different people to hang out with. Fourth, for many of us in the programming community, conferences are emotionally exhausting. We tend to be more solitary creatures. This aspect drains our social batteries, so make sure you take some intentional time to rest, walk along the beach, see what other things are available locally. And finally, speak or volunteer at the conferences to get into the conference for free and get the conference to pay for at least some of your travel expenses. This is, well, how I do every conference. That's not for everyone, but I really do recommend speaking at conferences at least once and see what you think of that experience. Okay, so that wraps up the aspect of Folkestone and C++ on C. Come back for a future episode to see our 2-day adventure in London.